So, it turns out Bruce Boudreaux is just a mere human after all. He is not some omnipotent deity like we had believed him to be after the Bruce there it is, after the point streak, after his arrival in Vancouver, the Messiah coming over here on an absolutely damned hockey team. He's just a normal guy. And honestly, that's okay. Because the Vancouver Canucks playing against the Florida Panthers here today, literally the best NHL team in the league, like, they're out there tied with Tampa Bay, I believe, in points, even though they have fewer games played than Tampa Bay. Tampa Bay is winning right now against Buffalo, I believe, or had they already won? I'm not really too sure. Let's go ahead and check out the results of that game right now. Yeah, okay, they beat Buffalo 6-1, so Tampa Bay, Florida, both of these teams, top of the NHL, and Florida has fewer games played, so taking a look at where everything is for both of these squads, they both have 53 points now. Florida has 36 games played, Tampa Bay has 38, and the Vancouver Canucks just lost to the best statistical team in the league. Is that a bad thing? I don't know if that's a bad thing. It's just kind of unfortunate because this was the start of a long and tedious and difficult road trip. It's not going to get any easier from here on out because the next game they're playing is against Tampa Bay, and that's going to be absolutely fun to watch at, like, when is it going to go on? 11 a.m. in the morning? Something like that? But either way, the Vancouver Canucks playing their first game since January 1st, playing only, like, their second or third game in a month? Yeah, it's been crazy with the NHL canceling games left and right. Or not even just the NHL, but Vancouver, the Canucks, and the home team canceling their own games at Rogers Arena left and right here. It's been very difficult to just keep finding ways to get excited because it's like, okay, how many days can we talk about how good X player is or how bad Y player is or how good Bruce Boudreaux is as a coach? I'll give the Canucks social media team full credit though because they're actually going out there making some really nice videos documenting the road trips, documenting the homestands, and then just giving us some good behind-the-scenes stuff. I liked the video they had today of the Bruce Boudreaux mic'd up in practice. That was a very good video. You can go ahead and watch that if you haven't seen it already. But ultimately, playing off against the best team in the NHL, the Florida Panthers, it is a 5-2 Florida win. And for Vancouver, I mean, this was one that you could definitely go out there and say the majority of the players out there did not have their best games. And it's easy to go out there and label right away, okay, Thatcher Demko, firstly, he's a guy that went out here and at one point in the game, he had let in 4 goals on 13 shots. So that's kind of the start the Canucks got off to if you want to get somewhat of an indicator of the direction over there. It was not a great start for Demko, even though he did have some pretty good robbery saves. It's just right from opening puck drop, right from the first shift or two, you could tell, based off of the way the Florida Panthers were moving around with the puck, based off of how quickly they were passing it around in the offensive zone, based off of the speed wherein they would pick the puck up, send it to another guy, move a few feet, and then pass it to somebody else, just based off of the systems that you could visually see, you don't need no analytics, no Corsi, no advanced stats to tell you this is a really gosh darn good hockey team. And the Vancouver Canucks got caught off guard quite significantly in the earlier stages of this game by the Panthers and their speed. It was overwhelming to watch this team just go around Vancouver and get some good chances. Demko stopped a few of them, and others, he was just kind of in the right place at the right time. The one that comes to my mind is Sam Bennett at the very beginning of the game, who came in on goal and he dangled the pants off of Demko, but he just slid the puck wide. That's one of those moments where it's like, yeah, if Demko was just kind of a little bit off, I mean, you probably would have seen Bennett just take advantage of the open space, but he kind of freaked himself out a little bit, which is why he dangled it a little bit too far to the side. It's no goal. It doesn't even get a shot on goal. It's still 0-0. Demko doesn't really make a save right off the bat or two, but immediately after a little bit more cycling around, eventually it's Anton Lundell who does a very nice initiation of the play. He takes a long shot that goes wide, or excuse me, a centering pass that goes wide. It deflects into the corner, fed back to Aaron Ekblad, who takes a shot. It goes by everybody. It's 1-0 Florida 5 minutes into the game. Then give it a minute or two, and another long shot gets tipped in. It's 2-0 Florida. This one was very nice. Radko Gudas with the long shot, and what a brilliant tip by Sam Reinhart, who stretches himself out and tips it like a good meter away from its original path. Demko gets beat. You can't really do anything about that if you're a goaltender there, especially with the screen that was in front. It's 2-0 Florida off of three shots in the span of like 6 minutes of game time. And the Canucks are getting shots of their own, too. They're going out there, putting the pressure on. Bobrovsky's making a few saves here and there. The Canucks get a power play, and Pearson gets a breakaway on that power play. He doesn't score. That's kind of where I was like, okay, we're going to lose this game. Like, Pearson not burying that power play opportunity and having the shots go the way they are, where it's like 7-3 Vancouver, yet they're down 2-0 in the game by goals. I was like, okay, it's going to be a long game here, isn't it? And eventually, we just see more of the same. Elias Pettersson had himself a high slot shot, but he elected to pass it to the faceoff dot instead. That was one of those where it's like, okay, if that was old Petey, probably would have ripped it in. Gustav Forsling, you remember him, right? Former Vancouver Canucks prospect who was eventually traded for Adam Clendenning to Chicago. Very terrible story. We're probably going to make a video about that soon, sometime down the line. He got himself a shot for Florida because he plays on that team now that went off the post. Eventually, the Canucks end up getting a goal here, which was probably the only saving grace of this game, where Jason Dickinson wins the draw, it goes back to Hunt at the blue line, he sends it into the corner for Garland, who takes it, throws it out to the faceoff dot once more, where Dickinson just takes it, he shoots it, he scores, it's 2-1, and that's pretty much the first period. The second period and beyond, I don't really want to talk about it. Just know that Bobrovsky made some saves. He had some really good opportunities that were thwarted away. Brock Besser had a chance that was point blank. Tyler Mott went to the penalty box. Jonathan Huberdeau scored on that power play. It was just such a good power play, dude. Look at how the Florida Panthers go out there and they move the puck around on the man advantage. They just cycle it, but while they cycle it, you can see the team kind of collapsing inwards, forcing the Vancouver Canucks to just kind of coagulate in the middle, giving the Panthers better angles and better distance towards the goal. It's a Huberto snipe that puts them up 3-1. Eventually, it's Anton Lundell a few minutes later who does a very nice drop pass to Mammon in the corner. Hoglander doesn't go with Mammon. He lets him go straight to the net, and he backhands it over Demko. It's 4-1 at this point, and there are only 13 Florida Panthers shots. Yeah, it wasn't a good game for Thatcher Demko statistically, and it gets even worse the further you go along, because the Panthers end up scoring a shorthanded goal before the end of the second period. It was a Vancouver power play where the puck gets deflected back to the blue line, and Barkov tips it by. Ekman Larson tries to get it and knock it down, but he's not able to. He's flat-footed. Barkov comes out with speed. He gets a breakaway, and Thatcher Demko just lets it go right by him. You can't stop Barkov on a breakaway, dude. Shorthanded, it's 5-1, and then the third period comes down, and all the notes that I have for the third period, it's just Miller drives the puck to the net and one-hands it. Hoglander had a brilliant drop pass to Petey, but he whiffed on it. The next shift, the Canucks scored off of a Brandon Montour play where he sort of put it into his own net. It looked like it was Lamico's goal, so it's 5-2. And then the rest of the game happens. The Canucks get a too-many-men penalty. Demko makes a goal line save on Huberto. Sam Bennett runs into Demko at the end of the game. The Canucks cannot convert on that power play. Miller missed an open net point-blank with a few seconds left on a brilliant cross-crease feed to extend his point streak to 10 games. And now the point streak is over. So that was the game. The Canucks ended up losing a game that they definitely should not have had any business winning. Sure, they got some chances. Sure, Demko made some good saves. But at the end of the day, this was the best team in the NHL just going to town on Vancouver. A Vancouver team that was well-rested, I guess. But, like, still, even though guys like Ekman Larson and other players on the team said, oh, yeah, you know, it's good to get the rest, good to get the body up and running, and you know, just making sure that everything is healing properly from the previous games. Even though that's the case, I don't want my team playing one hockey game every 11 days. Like, bro, we'll see what happens when they play Tampa Bay on Thursday or whenever the heck that game is going to be. I'm very much looking forward to that, eh? The road trip continues, baby. Bruce, there it is. We'll see what happens with the Vancouver Canucks and their playoff hopes. But one thing's for sure, this road trip is probably going to be super, super paramount in deciding where everything goes and where those dominoes fall into place. Talk to me in the comments. What do you think? about tonight's Canucks versus Florida Panthers game. The Canucks ended up losing a bad one, but it probably was very well deserved. I hope you enjoyed this Vitrage Rose 99. And bye.